A portion of this video is brought to you by ZipRecruiter. Who doesn't want a smartphone, laptop, or EV that can charge in minutes? Or a device that holds its charge just as well when it's 5 years old as the day that you plugged it in for the first time? Faster charging, longer lasting, and cheaper energy storage options are something that will benefit our daily lives. But unfortunately, the reigning battery champ, lithium ion, leaves something to be desired. Thankfully, there's a huge number of alternatives or evolutions in the works. So many, in fact, that it can be hard to keep track of them all. Let's take a look at five contenders, if they're overhyped, and when they might end up in our smartphones, homes, or EVs. What does the future look like for us beyond the tried and true lithium-ion battery? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. I'm fascinated by battery technology because it's a key component in virtually every piece of emerging tech, from personal devices like smartphones, cameras, and wearables, to home energy storage and electric vehicles. A stronger, lighter battery is critical to electric mobility. A highly resilient and long-lasting battery is critical for grid and home energy storage, which is of course essential for intermittent renewables like solar and wind. Another important goal is to improve battery supply chains and recycling efforts, which can be partially addressed by the battery technology itself. I've covered a lot of unique batteries this past year with exciting properties. In fact, there's been so many that it's made our collective heads spin. Now, a bunch of you have asked for a recap or a comparison video, so today I want to give you a roundup of five novel batteries to keep an eye on in 2023 and beyond. Now, before we get into the list, there's just a few things to keep in mind. First, each of these batteries could have their own video. In fact, some of them already do. So I'll include links in the description for those if you want to see more. For the ones I haven't done a dedicated video on yet, drop a comment for which ones you'd like to see. And second thing is that this is not a comprehensive list of every battery technology that's out there. That would be an absurdly long and boring video. And the last thing that you should also know is that these are not ranked by order of importance or viability. It's just a random list of the top five. So let's kick things off with our baseline for comparing everything else against, and that's lithium ion. And to be specific, a nickel manganese cobalt or NMC lithium ion battery. So why is lithium king? Well, as the lightest metal on the periodic table and among the most eager to shed its electrons, lithium makes a great battery. They're relatively lightweight, charge quickly, and have both good energy density and cycle life. There's several different ways to formulate the chemistry of lithium batteries, but we'll focus on nickel manganese cobalt or NMC because of its all-around great stats. Now, even within the high-performing lithium-ion battery family, NMC batteries are cheaper and more energy dense than its peers. It has a very good specific energy or energy density between 150 and 250 watt-hours per kilogram in most cases. And you can also count on NMC batteries for great performance with a cycle life of around 1,000 to 2,000 cycles. And a charging C rate of around 0.7 to 1C, and a discharge of 1 to 2C. In case you don't know what a C rate is, it's a relative metric on how fast a battery can be fully charged or discharged. A battery's fully charged capacity is commonly rated at 1C, which means that a 1 amp hour battery would provide 1 amp for 1 hour. You can apply this to how fast a battery charges and discharges. For instance, a C rate of 1C means it can go from 0 to 100% in 1 hour. A C rate of 2C is twice as fast, while a 0.5C would be half as fast. When you take into account the long history of lithium-ion batteries with their proven reliability and performance, it's easy to see why lithium-ion is truly the battery to beat. But before we get into the five contenders trying to take on this heavyweight champ, I want to thank and talk about today's sponsor, ZipRecruiter, who has a very direct connection to this video. Now, pulling these videos together often takes a lot of time, from researching and digging into the details of different technologies that I talk about, to editing the final video. I've built out a small team that helps with those tasks and to pull these videos together every single week. And one of my ZipRecruiter hires worked on this video. Now, finding and hiring the right people can be challenging. Now, I used ZipRecruiter long before they were a sponsor, and it really does make the process fast and easy. Their technology is fantastic at finding the right candidates for your job posting. You can quickly invite those matches to apply for your job, and your dashboard makes it really easy to review and rate all the applicants. See how much easier hiring is with ZipRecruiter. 4 out of 5 employers who post on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. And now you can go to this exclusive web address to try ZipRecruiter for free at ziprecruiter.com/undecided. Again, that's ZipRecruiter.com/UNDECIDED. Thanks to ZipRecruiter and to all of you for supporting the channel. So who could take on the heavyweight battery champ? Well, our first contender who's entering the ring is Solid State. here's a battery that's been heavily hyped for a long time. Solid-state batteries, which replace the liquid electrolyte with a solid one, like glass or ceramic, are appealing because they solve so many issues with lithium ion, while eternally being just a few years away from commercialization. And these batteries have a solid energy density of 250 to 300 watt hours per kilogram, and some reports of up to around 500 watt hours per kilogram, and a healthy 5,000 cycle life, depending on the charge and discharge rate. Some recent findings on glass batteries indicate the possibility of a mind-bending 23,000 discharge cycles. US-based manufacturer QuantumScape has been testing its batteries between a 1C and 4C rate, but they don't have an absurdly high cycle life. However, solid-state batteries are still expensive to make. These batteries are most likely going to start trickling out into the world through specific consumer electronics and maybe EVs at first, mainly because of the premium price that'll stick around for some time. Nobel Prize laureate, lithium battery father, and glass solid-state battery pioneer John B. Goodenough doesn't think we'll see batteries for another 5 years or so. It'll be even longer before they're affordable enough to make it into EVs, where they can really make a huge difference. Number two is sodium. When you look at the periodic table, you'll notice that sodium is right next to lithium. Sodium and lithium are atomically very similar, but sodium is far more abundant. Sodium ion batteries have a great longevity at 2,000 cycles, but the cycle life is still improving. You do have to take this benefit with a grain of salt, though, because sodium batteries lag behind NMC batteries in energy density at only 70 to 160 watt hours per kilogram. That said, 200 watt hours per kilogram is a real possibility in the future. One area where sodium really kills it is cost. For comparison, the price of lithium hydroxide rose from $6,800 in 2019 to $78,000 per metric ton, while sodium hydroxide is below $800 per metric ton. Sodium shares production methods and components with lithium, which also helps to make it cheap and easy to transition to sodium ion manufacturing. Now, while the stats are promising, sodium batteries, watt hour per kilogram, make them better suited for stationary storage applications at the moment. So I wouldn't expect these in an EV. At the same time, we shouldn't have to wait too long to see if these batteries can live up to their potential. Developers like Ferridian, located in England and Wales, are about to transition from pilot to commercial scale production. And Chinese battery giant CATL says its sodium ion batteries should be on the market this year. Number three, aluminum ion. As I've covered in a previous video, aluminum ion batteries are conceptually similar to standard lithium batteries, except that aluminum can theoretically exchange more electrons per ion. More electrons exchanged per ion means a higher energy density and capacity, at least in theory. Now, in collaboration with the University of Queensland, Australian company Graphene Manufacturing Group, or GMG, has developed an aluminum ion battery with an energy density of 160 watt hours per kilogram. Now, more recent tests have doubled that figure. Outside of GMG, statistics show possible energy densities around 200 watt hours per kilogram, cycle lives around 6,000, and a C rate of 6C for charge and discharge. Some of the big benefits of aluminum are its price, availability, and ease of recycling. The aluminum and graphene in GMG's battery in particular are excellent at transferring the heat out and away from the cell. This means less space, energy, and cost around cooling systems. This all comes together to make a very safe, affordable, and green battery. GMG's batteries are currently in their pilot phase, but are ramping up with early partners and planning on marketing an EV pouch cell in 2024. Number four is niobium. A niobium anode allows this type of battery to sidestep the intercalation problem that stops most other batteries from charging up at a fast rate. In a lithium-ion battery, intercalation is the process of moving the lithium ion from the cathode and inserting it into the graphite anode. It's the reversible process of storing molecules or ions within layered structures. There's only so fast this process can happen. Niobium's structure allows for extremely fast charging and discharging, which means that niobium batteries function more like a capacitor than a traditional battery. It's actually not that far off from the super battery, a supercapacitor battery hybrid, which is produced by Skeleton Technologies in Estonia and Germany. Now, across the pond, Battery Streak is currently trying to commercialize niobium technology from its California headquarters. Its battery can achieve an 80% charge in only 10 minutes. That's a C rate of about 6C. Now, this speed also doesn't sacrifice much energy density, as these batteries can pack around 140 watt hours per kilogram with the goal of about 180, and they last a strong 3,000 cycles. But Battery Streak has tested them up to 9,000 charge cycles. Niobium batteries can also stay very cool, unlike most other batteries. While standard battery's temperature gradient is around 27C, a niobium battery's temperature gradient is significantly lower at 8C. So where's the downside? Well, just like any other battery that we've talked about with a very high charge rate, it's an infrastructure problem. Even if you put this into an EV, there's nothing available right now that could charge it at full capacity. Both BatteryStreak and CBMM, a Brazilian company specializing in niobium products, are hopeful that commercialization for this can begin this year or in 2024. Number five is lithium sulfur. Now, this is a battery that showcases how little tweaks and advances can make a big difference. Lithium sulfur batteries are chemically and structurally similar to our standard lithium ion batteries. They switch things up by substituting a lithium cathode for a sulfur cathode and a heavy metal anode for one made of lithium. And these batteries have achieved an energy density of around 443 watt hours per kilogram. This is a shockingly energy dense battery, but their density comes at a cost because lithium sulfur batteries degrade like no other. Their chemical formulation makes them susceptible to something called the polysulfide shuttle, which sadly is not a type of line dance. It's an adverse chemical reaction between the polysulfides and the carbonate electrolyte solution, and it can coat the anode and prevent the battery from working very quickly. There is hope though. Researchers at Drexel University in Pennsylvania have successfully bypassed the problem and created a battery with a 4,000 plus cycle life. As for its tested C rate, it's around 0.5C, so there's still room for improvement there compared to some of the other batteries. Drexel's battery is still in the lab and needs more testing and refinement. Meanwhile, the California-based company Lyten is developing its own version of a sulfur battery with about a 1,400 cycle life. It's currently in the pilot phase, so hopefully we'll hear more about that later in this year. And this is far from an exhaustive list. I could have included redox flow batteries, iron air batteries, liquid metal batteries, and the super battery developed by Skeleton Technologies that I mentioned earlier. Now, I've got videos on most of those, which I'll include in the description. But the main reason I didn't include them on this list was some limitations around the use case. Most of them are generally meant for grid-scale energy storage. And these five that I did highlight potentially end up in a consumer electronics, electric vehicles, and home storage. So what does this all mean? Well, if you're playing emerging technology bingo, let me give you your free space. There's never going to be one battery to rule them all. Some batteries might be a viable alternative for EVs, while others are better suited for stationary energy storage, and then the list kind of goes on from there. Truth be told, none of these batteries are likely to dethrone lithium entirely. However, many of them have the potential to complement or to supplement lithium in general. A few could even supplant lithium in specific use cases. As these battery technologies eventually find their niches and hit their stride, they'll reduce our dependence on lithium. We'll be able to save it for just the applications where it does the best work, allowing us to enjoy its benefits without compromising our march towards a brighter, greener future. So what batteries do you think have a good shot? And would you add any to the list? Jump in the comments and let me know. And be sure to check out my follow-up podcast, Still To Be Determined, where I'll be discussing some of your feedback. And if you like this video, be sure to check out one of the ones over here. And thanks to all my patrons who get ad-free versions of every video for your continued support. And welcome to new Supporter Plus member, Brian Hargrove. You're helping me reduce my dependence on YouTube to pay for producing these videos. And thanks to all of you for watching and commenting. I'll see you in the next one.